Hi, I'm Dan Flynn, and today I'd like to tie a White Marabou streamer for you. This is it's an adaptation of a classic Maine streamer fly. It's just one that I like to tie, and I started tying it about 15, 20 years ago for brook trout fishing in Maine. And it's in no way a classic Maine streamer, but it's got some components of a classic Maine streamer. And it's got some yellow, some red in it, some silver, some marabou for motion, for a classic marabou streamer motion. So I found it to be pretty effective. And again, it's got a lot of components of a classic Maine streamer. So again, let's tie this fly. The first step to this fly is to tie on a tag, and I use red 8/0 thread for the tag. So I'll just tie it here at the bend of the hook, clip off the excess, and build up a little base here. And this will become the tag of the fly. All right, that's it. And I'll just tie this forward, and I'll tie on my black thread right over that, that I'll use to tie the rest of the fly with. And my little shaky little vise here that rattles all over the place. Here we go. All right. Next step of the fly is to tie in the tail. And for that we use a feather from a silver pheasant neck. And this is the yellow feathers that you get off a silver pheasant neck. And we'll just lay that right over the rear of the fly, and we'll tie that in just above the tag. There we go. Yeah, I think that's about where we want it. Next, we'll tie in the body for this fly. And for that, I'm going to use silver braid. Okay. We'll just tie that in. And we'll bring our thread forward. And we'll wrap in our silver braid body. And I end up putting double wraps in places to get it to even out to my liking, so that it's all as uniform as I can get it. And it looks like I measured out my silver tinsel just about right. Any shorter and I'd have been in trouble. And we'll just tie that off. Right. Next step of this fly is going to be to tie in the underwing materials, and for that, the first underwing material that I'm going to use is some red bucktail. So it's going to be fairly sparse. So what I've done is I've just cut some red bucktail off of the patch, and I haven't stacked it. I want it to be uneven lengths, and that'll just help the hair taper. So we'll just pull that on top of the hook shank, and we'll tie that in. Again, it's very sparse, just for a flash of red. We'll cut the end of that off. Then the next step is to tie some crystal flash right over that red bucktail. So we'll just take half a dozen strands or so of crystal flash, pearl crystal flash, or I think this is actually peacock crystal flash. Clip the ends, even them up, lay them down about the same length as the bucktail. Tie that to the top of the hook. And clip that off. All right. Now we'll tie in our marabou wing. For that, I've selected just a white marabou plume. I'll wet my fingers a little bit, and we'll stroke that to get it to where we can work with it a little bit better. There we go. I'm just going to lay that right on top of the hook and tie that in. About like that, so that the tip of the marabou feather extends just beyond the bucktail and the flash that we just tied in. All right, now I'll clip this off. Now I will tie a throat on this fly using another silver pheasant body feather, yellow body feather. I guess it's a body feather. It comes off of the head actually, but we'll just tie that to the bottom of the hook shank for the throat. Cut that off. All right, there it is. Now, the last thing we'll tie on this fly is a topping of peacock. So I've got, you take three or four strands of peacock pearl, lay that along the top of the marabou feather so that it extends to the end of the marabou feather. And just tie that right in. All right. All right, now all that's left to do is wrap in the head, cover up the materials, get that all nice and secure in there. Simple half hitch. And that's how I tie this white marabou streamer. I like fishing this fly here in the southeast where I live. A lot of the pools and runs that I fish this fly in are not very big and not very long, so I typically incorporate some weight into the shank of the fly, to the body of the fly, to get it down quick. And sometimes I have to impart the action of the fly using my rod tip rather than stripping the fly because the runs and pulls are so small. But I find that this fly is very effective fishing the small freestone streams here in the southeast. And although I originally started tying it and fishing it for brook trout in Maine, I now fish it quite a bit here in the southeast. So. Hope it works for you like it has for me.